right, I'm in Rydell, Georgia at the trim yard. We are waiting on a load. There was about 21 trucks in the yard last night. So I don't think we're going to get out of here anytime soon. This is like the army, man. You hurry up and wait. So let's study our Bible. I'm in Matthew chapter 3. And I might step on some sacred cows here today, but let's just see what the Bible has to say. A lot of people say, I want to be baptized with the Holy Ghost and with fire. And you hear that a lot. And I know they're sincere, good Christian people, but let's see what the Bible has to say about that. I'm starting in verse 7. In this Bible here, the small numbers are like that. When you see a big one, that's the start of a paragraph. So this is starting the paragraph right here. Let's look at it. But when he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees come to his baptism, he said unto them, O generation of vipers, who hath warned you to flee from the wrath to come? So the context is talking about wrath. He's talking to the Sadducees and Pharisees about wrath here. He said, bring forth therefore fruits meet to for repentance, and think not to say within yourselves, we have Abraham to our father. For I say unto you, that God is able of these stones to raise up children unto Abraham. And now also the axe is laid unto the root of the trees. Therefore, every tree which bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. First occurrence of the word fire. And it is not a good context. This is the verse that everyone quotes. I indeed baptize you with water unto repentance. But he that cometh after me is mightier than I, whose shoes I am not worthy to bear. He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost, comma, and with fire. Second occurrence of the word fire in this context. If you study your Bible, you know context, context, context. Whose fan is in his hand, and he will thoroughly purge his floor and gather his wheat into the garner, but he will burn up the chaff with unquenchable fire. Again, three times the word fire used in this context, all of them speaking of hell, not the Holy Ghost and fire. You're not going to get a burning fire in your gut. You're either baptized with the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, or you're baptized with fire. That is the context. That's what he's talking about right here in this section. That is obvious. And another thing that I like to bring out right here is there is another baptism, a way more important baptism than water baptism, shown here. Now, the cross reference with this is Mark and Luke. And in Mark chapter 1, let's see, and verse 8, let's start with verse 7. Now, in this context, he doesn't mention the Sadducees. He's not mentioning wrath. Mark was right to the point. He was getting his story told. And he not so much left out things, but he just told it real, you know, it was like the cliff notes, if you will. He said in verse 7, he says, and preach saying, there cometh one mightier than I after me, the latchet of whose shoes I am not worthy to stoop down and unloose. I indeed have baptized you with water, but he shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and fire. No, it doesn't say anything about fire because he's not mentioning anything about the wrath in this section of the book. Let's go to Luke, and he does, and it's in the same context that Matthew is. He just says it a little bit different. And let's start with verse 15. He says, "As the people were in expectation, and all men mused in their hearts of John whether he were the Christ or not, John answered, saying unto them all, I indeed baptize you with water, but one mightier than I cometh, the latchet of whose shoes I am not worthy to unloose. He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire." Okay, there's the word fire. Let's take it in context in the King James Bible. "Whose fan is in his hand, and he will thoroughly purge his floor, and will gather the wheat into his garner, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire. And many other things in his exhortation preached he unto the people." So in the context, in the Bible, you do not want to be baptized with fire, folks. Baptism is totally submerged. You're either going to be totally submerged with the Holy Spirit of God, praise God and the Lamb forevermore, hallelujah, or you are going to be purged in fire. Unquenchable fire, it says right there. All right, thank you for listening, if you listen to the end. Remember to read these Bibles. This is why it's so important to study to show yourself approved. I love my Pentecostal brethren. I do. I love the Baptist brethren that believe this, and they quote this all the time, and they want to be baptized with fire. You do not want to be baptized with fire, folks. You want to be baptized with the Holy Ghost. It's two different things. All right, have a wonderful day. Remember to read these books and pray without ceasing.